In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a heating boost automation. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and today we're going to create a simple heating boost automation using Node-RED. We can then create a card in Lovelace to go with it, so let's get going. So this automation does what it says on the tin. When you trigger it, it'll boost the heating to a predefined temperature for a certain duration, and after that duration, it'll revert back to the schedule. To make this work, we're going to need a few inputs. We're going to need an input boolean, an input select, and an input number. As you can see, mine are all referenced in separate files, so we're going to add these entities in those files now. The input boolean is used to trigger the heating boost. We'll call it heating boost. Imaginative, I know. We're going to set the initial to off, so we don't accidentally trigger the boost automation when we restart Home Assistant. And then we're going to add an icon as a radiator. For the input number, it's the same principle. We're going to use it to select how long we want to boost for. We'll call it hour, set the initial to 0, set the range between 0 and 5, and the step as 0.25. You can of course change these numbers if you want, but I think it's unlikely that you're going to want to boost your heating for more than 5 hours, or have more finer control than 15 minute intervals. Lastly, we use the input select. This is going to choose which room we activate the boost in. So we name it, and we add all the options, i.e. all the rooms. I'm going to set the initial to dining room, as this is where I'm most likely going to need my heating boost. We're also going to add a sensor. This is going to tell us what time the boost is due to finish. Again, mine are referenced in a separate folder, so we'll go to the sensors file now. This is going to be a platform of a template sensor. And then we input this as our value template. Don't ask me where I got it from, it took a lot of Googling and a lot of confusing working out, but you can just copy mine from the GitHub. Basically, it gets the current time and adds the delay time to it to create the end time. One problem with this sensor is it doesn't work with BST. I'm sure there's a simple workaround, probably involving a binary sensor telling you whether it's British summertime or not, and if it is, you just add an hour into this template sensor. Equally, I haven't figured it out and I haven't put it in, and I know if I'm boosting for 2 hours, the end time is not going to be an hour away. So I just leave it as it is. We can save, check our config, and restart Home Assistant. All these new entities should appear in our Developers tab. Now we can head over to Node-RED. Of course, I'll add this flow to my GitHub, so you can copy it and download it later. In fact, I suggest you download it and import it now into your Node-RED, so you can follow the rest of this video with the flow in front of you. We're going to need a number of nodes for this. We start off with an event state node, then we have a couple of cool service nodes, a merge node and a switch node. After that, we have a change node, another cool service node, a calculator node, a delay node, and then the final cool service node. The event state node is to trigger the boost if our input boolean is on. Oh, I also forgot we need another delay node and a call service node to turn the input boolean off after a short period of time. That means it's reusable, ready for next time we want it. The two call service nodes are to get the room from the input select and the delay from the input number. And we can then merge them into the switch node. As far as I can tell, merging is the only way to get multiple bits of information through a switch node, only switching on one of the bits of information. So then in our switch node, we're going to switch based on the value of message.payload0.payload. Payload 0 is the room information, because it's the first thing that went into the merge. Payload 1 would be the delay information, but we don't want to switch on that, we're only switching on the room information. We then add as all our conditions the separate rooms, making them equals and giving them the name that we used in the input select. Next we move on to the change node. This change node will set our delay from the message payload 1 to message.delay, and then it can be read by our delay node later on. The first call service node is going to be to set our temperature of our climate to 21 degrees. So we use the service set temperature, enter our climate as the entered ID, and then in data, we set the temperature to be 21 degrees. Next up is the calculator node. We use this to convert from hours, which we set in our input number, to milliseconds for the delay node to understand. So we multiply our delay by 3.6 million. Next, we have the delay node. We set this to be variable based on message.delay. And lastly, we have our final call service node. This is used to return the heating back to the schedule. With the Evo Home setup that I use, there's actually a service to remove the override from the heating system. So I'm going to use that service here. It's called Clear Zone Override. And then I obviously need to set the entity to the climate that it's going to be clearing. If you don't have that option in your heating system, then you can just turn the heating off at this point, or just set the temperature to a lower value. We can shimmy them around to take up a bit less space, and then we can copy and paste it for all the rooms. We connect each one to a separate output of the switch node, and then we need to make sure we change the entity in our call service nodes so it matches the output of the switch node. Once that's done, we can deploy and move on to Lovelace. My Lovelace for this is very simple. It's just an entities card. So we're going to add that new entities card now. In here, we're going to give it a title and turn off the header toggle. We can then add our entities. We're going to add the input boolean to command the boost to happen, the sensor for the end time, the select for the rooms, and the number for the delay time. Once that's happy, we can save it and check out our Lovelace. If you've enjoyed this video, then please consider giving it a thumbs up or leaving me a comment below so the wizards at YouTube HQ will recommend my video to you and others much more often. So there we have it, a very simple heating boost automation. Make sure you hit subscribe below and click the bell icon to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.